Good afternoon. Since my last video, when did we last speak? Like last week? Yes, talking about those two chicks fighting. I did a few more pieces since then. Not that many, maybe about four. I did a handful. I can't even remember. Oh, that's pitiful. Let's just start, okay? I did a few more pieces. Starting with this one. Now, this is a book that I showed you all 3 years ago when I did my first Inktober with you. So, again, procrastination is real. It's a problem. All right. This one. This is Prince in the 70s. These are two Prince pictures I'm about to... Well, actually, ooh. Let me think. There are three Prince pictures here that you're going to see today. And you'll deal. Okay, so this is Prince in like the 70s. He's like a teenager or something. My only problem with this picture is that his eyes are slightly too close together. So, I mean, I don't know that you would readily know that's him. But it came out nicely. Like I used ink wash and a ballpoint pen. A more recognizable version of him. He's backstage somewhere in the 80s. I'm assuming either somewhere around Purple Rain, maybe 1999 at earliest. The album, not the actual year. I liked this one. I wanted it to be quick, but I wanted it to be detailed enough for you to know exactly who it is, and obviously you do. So I was satisfied with this one. The other one in here, I will show you in a moment. I'm gonna show you my process for that one. All right, so this one, this little Moleskine book has ended up being more tried and true than I realized it would be. I like this book. Are my hands ashy? Ugh. Whatever. Okay, so remember when I told y'all Inktober was trying it? Sure you do. All right. Okay, see this picture? Still ugly. But I drew this one. The only problem I have with this one, again, is that the Eiffel Tower came out kind of botched. And I talked about that on Instagram. But overall, the vibe of the picture is what I wanted. This is actually reference from a photo of Nicole Richie, who I love because she is my spirit animal. Okay, again, there's another picture behind this, but I'm going to show you that as well. I ended up, the two pictures I decided to show you the process for, like semi-time lapse, what have you, they ended up being pictures I got very excited about drawing, so I figured I would just capture the whole process or the majority of it. And they both ended up very nice, so I wanted to show you how I went about them. Oh, hello again. Glad to see you. Long time no see. So with this one, whenever I saw the actual picture, this is Prince, just in case you have no clue, which I doubt. This is a picture, a screen cap from Under the Cherry Moon. It's the movie he made after Purple Rain. Under the Cherry Moon was not good. It's a movie for Prince fans. Like if you're a real Prince fan, that's pretty much the only way you might get through this movie. I mean, it's cute. You know what's best about it? Kiss is from this era. And the outfits he wears. That's about as great as it gets. And it's kind of silly. It's got some funny points in it. But overall, it's not his best. Okay? If we're just being completely honest. So with this picture, I like this shot very much. It's glamorous, a little condescending. That was kind of his resting face anyway, so I don't know that the condescension is anything special about this photo. It's just how he looks. It kind of looks like he's like side-eyeing you, like he just shaded you and dares you to have something to say after, like what? Oh, that's what I thought. You know what I'm saying? That's the look he always has on his face. So this picture is no different. With this picture, I wanted to evoke the same type of vibe the actual photograph had. Very film noir, romantic, soft. So that's why I was very particular about doing very, very light strokes and layers with very, very diluted bits of ink wash. You saw that I was spraying my little plate of ink, and I didn't even dip into the ink bottle. I just kind of swirled. I swirled the brush around in the dry ink just to create this kind of dirty water, because that's basically what I wanted to work with, and you can see that it works just fine. I didn't want to do anything too dark because the actual photo is not, it's not a dark one. It's very soft. A few things I noticed this year, about my overall habits when it comes to drawing was that I'm very heavy-handed. I get stressed and very aggressive with the pen if I find that something is kind of close to not what I want, or if I'm trying to correct something, or I get really tense for whatever reason. I'm very aggressive with the pen. So what I wanted to focus on this go round was being as light-handed as possible, just more delicate lines. And you can always go back and make them darker. Another thing is making sure that I don't draw when I'm tired or when I'm getting frustrated or if the drawing's not going the way I want and every avenue I exhaust is not working. I had to stop, go rest, just let it sit for a while and come back to it. This drawing did not give me a lot of trouble. I was just very particular about it looking exactly like him. I really didn't want anything to be off. That's what stresses me about drawing familiar figures is that, wait, hold on. Hold that thought. Look at what's happening with this eye right now. And this is what I mean by heavy-handedness and getting tense and stressed out. I made him completely cockeyed, and you'll see that the eye is fine now because I stopped the camera and I took a breather and I went and got some acrylic white paint and just dabbed until it was white again and fixed that mistake. That was kind of almost a tragedy. Back to what I was discussing. What stresses me about drawing familiar public figures is that there's that pressure to make it look exactly like them or enough like them to where when a person looks at it or whenever you look at it, you know who it is. And that's the only thing I don't enjoy about doing it. What I do love is whenever it works out. The only thing that probably gave me issues were maybe his eye, making sure his cheek was just angular enough. I wanted his brows to be correct. And that little area under his lip, what is that, his vestibule? That little chunky area, a little area that curves out a little bit just outside his lip, almost like he's got dip in his mouth. That's how he looks like. I had to remember while he looked like a woman, he's not a woman. He has a very delicate face, but I couldn't make it so delicate he looked like a woman, right? He still has masculine features in his face. So I still needed to provide that balance where, yes, Prince is very doll-faced and beautiful and elegant and soft, but he was still very much a man with angular, manly features. And so that was also a challenge. My goal, again, was soft brushes. You can see I went in with different layers and chose areas to do light strokes to provide dimension to his super greasy hair. This part with the collar, it had a more precise print, like a very Baroque print on his suit. If you've seen the movie, you know exactly what I'm talking about. The paper was still too wet to provide that precision. And I didn't really care because after it dried, I just went in with a pen and kind of sharpened everything up. This is my favorite part. You see me put this ink in here. Ooh, she loves a metallic detail. can see how it came out. It was perfect. It was soft. It was perfect. I love how it came out. It was wonderful. I'm very happy with it. On to the next. Okay, this gentleman. This one was another one I was very excited to draw because the actual photograph is very beautiful. It's by, their name is Ambient Jade. Now, I loved this one because I really just wanted to, I wanted to approach it from a very, how do I word this? I just wanted to go straight in with the pen. I didn't want any kind of sketching. You see, the other one was very refined and polished, and I was very particular and was kind of a perfectionist about it, and I wanted everything to look a certain way, so I used a pencil with the last one. With this one, I chose to put this in here because I wanted to show you another method I use, which was the method I used throughout Inktober, and the main challenge that I might have mentioned with you all in the beginning of the month, and that was to be more raw with my drawing. Just go straight in with the pen, no pre-sketches, no nothing. Just really test out my skill and develop it from there. And as you can see, I had a few hiccups while creating the profile, but it still started coming together, and I really like that because I didn't have the luxury of going back and erasing or correcting or anything like that. I just had to kind of go with the flow, and whatever happens, happens. There was something very, there's a lot of confidence built with this one, and it was very liberating. Not really doing that perfectionist stuff like doing the pencil first. I really kind of got into the vibe of Inktober by not doing pre-sketches on all my work. You kind of really get a gauge of where your skill level is when you do it that way. At least that's how I see it. This one and the prints one ended up being my favorite ones of the entire month. And that's why I wanted to share them with y'all. My Pentel pocket brush pen made a brief return. I haven't used that in a minute. I haven't used that one since last year. So I figured it would be appropriate to fill the hair in with that. I finished this one moderately quickly too. I like that as well. I was going back and forth with whether or not I should show you my process. And I'm glad I'm showing it to you now. I didn't want to be all particular about editing when it came to doing the time lapse. I kind of just threw all the footage on there and sped it up. I didn't feel like clipping and taking out all the lagging or the stopping or anything like that. I wanted you to kind of see my process a little bit more in depth with these two. And again, ta-da! It's beautiful. I love it. I love it. Do you love it? I think you'll love it. Just admit it. Just admit it. And then once you admit it, I want you to subscribe. All right. That was my Inktober. Thank you for watching once again, and I'll talk to you when I talk to you. God bless. Bye.